Hello dear students, good morning. Hope you all fine, doing good, and welcome to commerce stream. The subjects whatever you are going to study are new to you. You might have read little bit about accountancy, little bit about business studies, economics, statistics, and any other subjects, but that gave you just little information. But here in PUC we are going to study in detail about the basic aspects of business studies. Okay, in the first chapter you have studied what is business, what are its characteristic features, what are the objectives of business. Conducting business is mainly for the purpose of earning profit, right? And how to start the business, what is the risk involved in that, right? How to start the business, first we have to pool an idea, then we have to conceive the opportunity, then we have to make arrangements, financial arrangements, then plant layout has to be planned, then we have to pool the resources, required resources, physical resources and financial resources, then we have to start production, right? So what business has to be undertaken, that we are going to study now. Okay, business means what? Producing or manufacturing or selling and purchasing of goods and services with an objective of earning profit. Labha galisuva uddeshadinda naavu yavade vastuvanna tayarisi athava adanna maarata maadidre adanna naavu en kariteve vyavahara anta kariteve. Okay, so we know how to conduct the business, but the question is what type of business to be conducted. Okay, I want to conduct business, nangon business maadbeku, what type of business to be conducted, yav tara business maadbeku nanu. So that idea, that information we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, the various forms of business, generally we find five forms of business, that is sole trading concern, joint Hindu family business, partnership firm, cooperative society and a joint stock company. If at all you want to start a business, then you can start sole trading concern, okay, you can start joint Hindu family business, you can start partnership firm, you can start cooperative society, or you can start joint stock company. In this chapter we are going to study about each and every prospect in detail. Okay, so today I will tell you what is sole trading concern, what are its merits and demerits. Often if we go out we find so many shops, maybe vegetable shop, maybe a bakery, maybe hotel or saloon or beauty parlor or any other that kind of shops. Okay, majority of the shops whatever we find out outside, they are sole trading concerns. Okay, so what is sole trading concern? If one person, sole means one, okay, if one person he invests money, okay, he decides about the stream of the business, okay, if he controls the business, and if he becomes the sole recipient for the profit, and if he alone bears the risk or losses, then such business is called as sole trading concern. Okay, ubbane bandavalavanna haki avanu aa vyavaharavanna sampurnavagi niyantrisi ಬರುವ ಲಾಭವನ್ನು ಅವನೊಬ್ಬನೇ ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ಆದಂತಹ ನಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಅವನೊಬ್ಬನೇ ಹೊಣೆಗಾರನಾದರೆ ಆಗ ನಾವದನ್ನು ಏನು ಕರಿತೇವೆ, ನಾವದನ್ನು ಏಕ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಟು ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಎನಿ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್, ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯಬಲ್ಸ್, ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಲೋನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆರ್ ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಲೋನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಸ್, ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು pool the financial resources and he has to decide what kind of business to be started, alva, vegetable shop or beauty parlor or restaurant or garment shop or automobiles or whatever, okay, he has to decide, hardware shop or medicals, he has to decide what type of business he is going to start, and he only should control the business, okay. He should decide about the place or the location of the business, and he only should decide about the items to be sold, the stock to be kept, the building, or whether he is going to own the building or he is paying rent for that. He has to decide, he has to work hard, he alone should take the profit, and if suppose loss occurs, then he alone should become responsible for losses. Such business is known as a sole trading concern, okay. So what are the characteristic features of this sole trading concern? In sole trading concern, what happens? Formation of the business and closure of the business is very easy, okay. Starting or forming a sole trading concern does not involve any procedure, okay. For example, you have D Pharma degree and you are willing to start one medical shop, then what is required? Permission from the respective municipality or gram panchayat is important, okay. If you take a permission to start the business, that is enough, okay. You need not register yourself, okay. You should have the D Pharma certificate, then you can start the business, and you will decide where to start, which building to occupy, right. It is left to you whether you purchase that particular block or you give rent for that. It's left to you, right. What about the amount of investment that you are going to start? That is also left to you, right. So you become the sole person to decide in the business what to do and what not to do, and it is not having much procedure, whereas in case of joint stock company, there is lengthier procedures, and those procedures are mandatory or compulsory, and without following those procedures, the business will not be considered as lawful business. But in case of sole trading concern, no much formalities are involved. Therefore, formation of the business and closure of the business is easy. Closure, right? If you are not willing to continue the business, then what you can do? Sell whatever the stock in your shop, okay? Sell it. Take money, whatever the loan you have or you have with banks, or whatever the money you have taken from your relatives or friends, you give it back to them, okay. And if you have taken the building on rent, hand it over to the owner, right, and just close the business, okay. Therefore, formation and closing of the business is very easy, okay. Second one, liability, okay. The liability of the sole trader is unlimited, okay. What is this liability? In case of loss, if suppose loss occurs, then the sole trader, he becomes the sole responsible person to pay back. Take for example, you have taken 5 lakh rupees loan from bank and you have started one garment shop. After some times, after 1 year or 2 years or 3 years, you are suffering from continuous loss. Customers are not visiting for various reasons. You suffer from loss. So what is your liability? The loan taken from bank, 5 lakh rupees, you have to pay back, even though there is no profit, even though your business is not in good position, it is your duty to pay back the loan, okay. Even though there is no profit, you have to give back loan along with the interest, okay. That is one of the important features of a sole trading concern. Whereas in joint stock company, we are going to study in the coming classes in detail, okay. I am just comparing for your knowledge. In joint stock company, what happens? If there is profit, then only we are giving amount or dividend to the shareholders. If there is no profit, we will tell them that there is no profit, so this year it is not possible to give dividend. So for the investors, we are giving dividend. So in the coming classes, I will tell you in detail what is dividend, what is the criteria for deciding percentage of dividend and all. Okay, so there declaration of dividend depends upon the profit, but in case of sole trading concern, we cannot say this year I have suffered from loss, so I'm sorry, I'm not able to give you back any loan or interest. Next year if I receive any profit, that time I will give you. It is not possible, right? Whether I receive profit or whether I suffer from loss, it is my duty to pay back loan. Okay, that is liability. Here liability of sole trading concern is unlimited. Okay, next, sole risk bearer and recipient. He is the only one person to enjoy the profit as well as to face or to bear the risk. If profit comes, he will enjoy completely. He need not give any share. But in case of partnership firm or in case of joint Hindu family business, what happens? If profit comes, then the profit has to be distributed among other members also. Partnership deed mentions about the profit sharing ratio, and profit has to be divided among the partners according to their partnership ratio. Okay, therefore that problem of sharing the profit is not there, but here the risk or the loss should also be borne by the single person. Avanobne labhavanna padittane ade reeti avanobbane baruva nashtakku kuda honegaranagirtane. Okay, then the next one is control. Control of the business is 100% in the hands of sole trader. He only decides what type of business to be conducted, where to conduct it, what about the stock, right? What amount of stock to be hold, and the interiors of the shop, what kind of interiors to attack the customers to do, and what about the sales promotion methods to involve. Okay, everything is decided by him, and what about the amount of investment, everything he decides. Therefore 100% control of the business is in his hands. Okay, then the next one is no separate entity. Okay, in accountancy there is one concept called separate entity concept. Accountancy is based on some of the concepts. Okay, one among them is separate entity concept. What separate entity concept says? It says that the owner is different and the business is different. We are maintaining accounts of the business but not the owner. Okay, therefore even if the owner is taking some amount or if he is taking some goods, then that is considered as drawings. Here business is having its own identity, therefore here it is very important to treat both separately. Therefore we are entering transactions only related to business. The personal transactions of the businessman or the owner, they are not considered, but that separate entity concept is not followed. Okay, owner and business are considered as same. Okay, therefore here no separate legal entity is one of the features of sole trading concern. And the last one is lack of business continuity. There is no guarantee that the business will continue forever. In case of other business, for example joint stock company, what happens? There is one principle called people may come, people may go, but the company continues forever, right? Take for example Infosys. Narayan Murthy, he is the founder of Infosys. He got retired recently, in his place somebody else came, right? Take for example Tata. Jamshed Tata, he started the business, right? We have seen the business tactics or the administration capabilities of Ratan Tata, right? Then Ratan Tata, he retired and somebody else came in his place, but the company continued, right? Therefore, in case of joint stock company, the presence of person is not important. Company continues. If one person dies or retires, then another person comes in his place. But in case of sole trading concern, if the sole trader dies, then there is no guarantee that his family members will continue, right? If continuous risk occurs in the business, then inevitably the owner will decide of closing of the business, right? Therefore, situation decides whether to continue the business or not. Therefore, there is no guarantee for the continuation of the business. These are the various characteristic features of a sole trading concern. Then what are the merits? If you opt sole trading concern as one of the business perspective, then what are the plus points that you are going to enjoy? Okay, the first one is a quick decision making. If I want to improve my business, then I can decide, right? Improvement in the sense, say for example, you have started one garment shop, small garment shop, okay, and that garment shop you can add a fancy store also, right? So you can decide. If you have money, if you have the capability to pool the resources, then you can develop your business. So whether to invest or not, whether to improve or not, right? Any decision related to the business you can take. Therefore, quick decision making is possible. Then the second advantage is confidentiality. Confidentiality about the business, the amount of money that whatever you have invested, that is confidential, right? The contacts you have, the customers you have, that is also confidential, right? So if you have your own hotel, then the some of the recipes, for example, in Dakshina Kannada, Kalladka tea is very famous. The recipe of tea is unique, it's not available elsewhere, right? So they don't share it because it's their business secret, right? If they share, then what will happen? Another person also will start the same kind of hotel and they also become famous, right? The trade secret will be no more secret. It will be no more confidential. So that confidentiality, it can be maintained in a sole trading concern. And sense of accomplishment. If you do hard work, then if you get result and you will be satisfied, right? You read well for the examination, you prepare well, you write well. If you receive 100 marks or 99 or 98, then you feel satisfied, right? For the work done by me, I have received this kind of reward and it will motivate for further hard work, right? Same way in sole trading concern also, the profit whatever received by him is enjoyed by him alone, right? If business is moving further towards the development and growth, then he will have a sense of accomplishment. ಒಂದು ತೃಪ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ನಾನು ಮಾಡಿದಂತಹ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲ ಬರ್ತಾ ಉಂಟು, ಪ್ರತಿಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಉಂಟು. ಆ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟು ಏನು ಉತ್ತೇಜನವನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದರ್ಫೋರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸರ್. ಆಸ್ ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಲಿಟೀಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ದರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮನಿ, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನಫ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ another field, then you can close the business. Okay, these are the positive sides of sole trading concern. Then what about the demerits? Resources are limited. Okay, you are the one person to invest money. If you are rich enough, if you have good financial background, then definitely you can invest money and you can start a business. But if you don't have money, if you have lack of finance, then ಯು ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ರೈಟ್. ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆದರೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ನ ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಇಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನಾವು ಹೋಟೆಲಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ನಾವೇನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ವಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಇಂಟೀರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ರೈಟ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಹೋಟೆಲನ್ನು ಹೊಕ್ಕುವ ಮೊದಲು ನಾವೇನು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಹೇಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಹಳೆಯ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಹರ್ಕು ಮುರ್ಕು ಟೇಬಲನ್ನು ಚೇರನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರಂತ ಆದರೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂತಹ ತಿಂಡಿ ತಿನಿಸು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ರುಚಿಕರವಾಗಿರಲಿ, ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಅದೇ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಇಂಟೀರಿಯರ್ ಇದೆ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಪಾರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್, ಈವನ್ ದೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಗೋ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಒನ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಕಸ್ಟಮರನ್ನು ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಶಾಪ್ ಕೂಡ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಲೊಕೇಶನಲ್ಲಿರಬೇಕು. ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಲೊಕೇಶನಲ್ಲಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಉಂಟು ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಆಗ ನಮಗೆ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಸನ್ನು ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ರೈಟ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಮಗೆ ಸಿಗುವ ಲೋನಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಲಿಮಿಟ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಆ ಲಿಮಿಟಿನ ಒಳಗೇ ನಾವು ಲೋನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಲೋನನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ವಾಪಸ್ ಕಟ್ಟಲಿಕ್ಕೂ ಕೂಡ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಆಗಬಹುದು. ದೆನ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಡಿಮೆರಿಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್, ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ ರೈಟ್. ಸೀ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್, ಮೆನಿ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೇ ಸಫರ್ಡ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್, ಈವನ್ ಟುಡೇ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್. ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪೀಕ್, ಬಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ COVID-19 ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್, ದ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ರಿಸ್ಕಿ ರೈಟ್. ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್, ದ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಓಪನ್ಡ್ ನಾವ್ ದೇ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಓವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಸ್ ಓನರ್ಸ್. ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಬಸ್ಸಸ್ ವೇರ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ದೇ ಕುಡ್ ರನ್ ದೇಯರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕುಡ್ ಗಿವ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಟು ಅದರ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ನಾವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಟ್ ದೇಯರ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್. ವೈ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಟ್ ದೇಯರ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನೋ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್. ವೈ ನೋ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ಆರ್ ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ಡ್ 4-wheelers ಆರ್ 2-wheelers ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಬಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ ರಿಸ್ಕಿ, ದರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಸ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪೇ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪೇ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್, ಟೋಟಲಿ ಲಾಸ್. ಸೊ ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅನ್ಸರ್ಟನಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಫೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಟಿ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಶ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಅನದರ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಡ್ರಾಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫೈನ್, ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್, ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅ ಲಾಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಎಲೋನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬೇರ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್. ಆ ಬಂದ ನಷ್ಟವನ್ನು ನೀವು ತುಂಬಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಿಮ್ಮ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕ ಆಸ್ತಿಪಾಸ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಮಾರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ತಯಾರಿರಬೇಕು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂದ ಲೋನ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ 10 lakh, ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಲಾಭ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಆದರೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿನವರಿಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಲಾಭ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಲಾಭ ಬಂದ ನಂತರ ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಲೋನನ್ನು ವಾಪಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ತಿಂಗಳು ತಿಂಗಳು ಅವರಿಗೆ EMI ನಾವು ಕೊಡಲೇಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆ ಲೋನನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಆಗ ನಾವು ಅಡವಿಟ್ಟಂತಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಸ್ತಿಪಾಸ್ತಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾರಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಸಂದರ್ಭ ಬರಬಹುದು ರೈಟ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಡ್ರಾಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರಿಯಲ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮನಿ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನಫ್ ರೈಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗುಡ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನಫ್. ಹೌ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಸಪ್ಲಾಯರ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ದ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಟು ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಟು ರಿಟೈನ್ ದ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ನೋನ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ರೈಟ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮನಿ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಹೌ to conduct the business. That is very important. If you do not have that managerial ability, then the business may fail. Okay, these are the demerits of sole trading concern: limited resource, limited life, unlimited liability, and limited managerial ability. So this is about sole trading concern. So if at all you have limited resource, and with the limited resource, if you are willing to start any business, then you can think of this sole trading concern, because it is easy to start, easy to close, and you are the single person to control the business, you are the single person to enjoy the profit, and if at all risk arises, you should bear the risk. Okay, so in the next class we will discuss about the second opportunity, that is joint Hindu family business. Okay, thank you.